Saat Dr. Shengmen membantu pasiennya dengan membersihkan arteri yang tersumbat melalui operasi angioplasti dan stenting, dia juga mendorong mereka untuk mengadopsi gaya hidup sehat. Dia bahkan telah menulis buku untuk publik pada topik berjudul Panduan dari Dokter Jantung Vegan untuk Membalikkan Penyakit Jantung, Menurunkan Berat Badan, dan Merebut Kembali Hidup Anda.
What I like to see my patients do is aim for at least 30 minutes of exercise most days of the week, preferably an hour, doing something to get your heart rate up, something that you enjoy doing, because if you don't enjoy doing it, then you're not going to stick with it.
Dalam seri ini, kami akan menyoroti saran bijaksana dari Dr. Shengmen tentang cara menghindari penyakit kardiovaskular atau CVD, suatu istilah umum yang merujuk pada kondisi yang mempengaruhi pembuluh darah jantung dan penyebab kematian nomor satu di seluruh dunia. Secara menyedihkan, membunuh 17,9 juta orang setiap tahun.
I've seen some wonderful things happen to my patients who've adopted plant-based diets. Of my patients who've had heart issues, of those who have gone plant-based in the course of my 11-year career, I have not seen a single one of them have another heart attack or stroke or need bypass surgery or need any further stents. One patient I was thinking about the other day, he's a gentleman I did an angioplasty on about a year ago at one of our local hospitals. A 52-year-old man came in with chest pain, was a smoker, not on medications, horrible, horrible diet. He was really, really sick. His heart stopped. We had to shock his heart. After we shocked his heart and we brought him back, he then proceeded to, on our procedure, throw up. And then he did what we call aspirated. In other words, he had some of those contents go down into his lungs. We got short of breath. We had to put him on a breathing machine. Finally, we stabilized him enough there that I was able to put a stent in and open the artery. He went home 3 days later, but before he went home, we had a long conversation about lifestyle and quitting smoking and exercise and a plant-based diet. And he really took it to heart. And he came back and saw me in a couple of weeks. He was doing really well. He had stayed off the cigarettes. I saw him a couple of months later. We reassessed his heart. At the time of his heart attack, his heart was very, very weak. A few months later, his heart pumping function had actually normalized. He had a normal looking strong heart. And I just saw him very recently. It's been a year since his heart attack. He signed up for a triathlon.
Kita sekarang akan jeda sejenak untuk satu pesan positif. Tetaplah bersama Supreme Master Television.
Welcome back to Dr. Heather Shenkman, an interventional cardiologist's Tips for a Healthy Heart, part 3 of 4 on Supreme Master Television. Dr. Yawurgana will now continue presenting our program.
Kami tertarik atas perjalanan Dr. Shengmen berpola makan nabati dan meminta dia untuk berbicara tentang pengalamannya.
Started out as a vegetarian when I was a teenager, and that was mostly at the annoyance, at least at that time, of my younger brother, who had become a vegetarian after being asked to dissect chicken wings in middle school. And it all resonated with me. He had a lot of literature from PETA and other places that came to our home about how animals lived horrible lives, and I said, you know, I don't want to eat animals anymore. So I became a vegetarian at 16, but I still ate dairy and eggs, and I didn't decide to take the leap and go plant-based or vegan until I was actually in my training for cardiology. So it was 13 years later. And much of that was due to the fact that I love animals, and if you hear about where dairy comes from and where eggs come from and the chickens that are crammed together in such small spaces their entire lives, It's not nice to the animals, but around that same time, I also learned about the work of Dr. Dean Ornish and Dr. Caldwell Esselstyn, who demonstrated in their research that a plant-based diet can actually reverse even the most severe of heart disease. So at that time, I was in my training to become a cardiologist. It really all kind of came together. And about 13 years ago, I gave up all animal products and went fully plant-based and haven't turned back since.
Menurut ulasan yang diterbitkan dalam jurnal Nutrients, mengikuti pola makan nabati dapat membantu mengurangi peradangan, yang berarti itu bisa mempercepat waktu pemulihan bagi para atlet. Seorang pencapai finish dari dua triathlon jarak Ironman, Dr. Shankman sendiri telah mengalami penyembuhan cepat ini setelah sesi pelatihan intens dirinya.
An Ironman distance triathlon is a triathlon that includes a 2.4-mile swim, 112-mile bike, followed by a 26.2-mile run. And this is all done in one day. You know, most competitors aren't plant-based, but one thing that I've always noticed is that compared to my teammates, is that when I have a hard workout, I always feel like I recover faster. Less soreness, or that soreness goes away quicker, and feeling like I have enough energy even like the next day or 2 days later.
Aktif dalam urusan masyarakat dan peduli akan kesejahteraan mereka yang ada di California, Amerika Serikat, sebuah negara bagian yang adalah penerima penghargaan kepemimpinan dunia cemerlang untuk perlindungan. Dr. Shankman telah dengan kukuh mendukung prakarsa-prakarsa memajukan kesehatan masyarakat. Saat ini, Undang-Undang Negara Bagian, Undang-Undang Senat 1138 mensyaratkan makanan vegan disediakan kepada mereka di rumah-rumah sakit dan penjara-penjara California. Undang-undang itu menyatakan bahwa akses untuk makanan bergizi yang sesuai untuk kesehatan atau kebutuhan budaya adalah hak asasi dasar manusia.
Well, I was contacted by a Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, and they had told me that there is this bill, Senate Bill 1138, that was going before the one of the committees, and they wanted somebody to testify in support of providing plant-based meals in hospitals and in prisons. So I had the opportunity to testify in front of the Senate committee. And what was exciting is that everybody who was present voted in favor of the bill.
Selain Undang-Undang Senat 1138, Dr. Shankman membantu dengan dimulainya satu program percontohan, pilihan makanan vegan pada sistem sekolah negeri terbesar di Amerika, Distrik Sekolah LA Unified yang melayani Los Angeles dan sekitarnya.
I was involved when it launched. I was invited to speak to the school board. Okay, in support of plant-based meals for kids in schools. Gets kids started off eating healthy, they'll grow up eating healthy, because a lot of kids don't start out eating the right foods. I mean, I speak to who I was. If you start off as a kid and you're eating junk, it's easy to keep eating junk. It's hard to make those changes.
Untuk informasi lebih lanjut tentang Dr. Shankman dan bukunya Panduan dari Dokter Jantung Vegan untuk membalikan penyakit jantung, penurunan berat badan, dan merebut kembali hidup Anda, silahkan kunjungi drheatershankman.com/about-the-book. Bergabunglah lagi dengan kami minggu depan pada hari Sabtu 7 September untuk Dr. Heather Shankman, kiat-kiat seorang kardiologis intervensional untuk jantung yang sehat, bagian 4 dari 4 seri, saat kita akan mencari tahu lebih banyak tentang buku Dr. Heather Shankman di antara topik menarik lainnya. Terima kasih pemirsa yang menyenangkan atas kebersamaan Anda pada acara hari ini.